What's up guys, it's Kevin with K-Squared Fitness. Today I'm going to be breaking down the Palloff split squat lunge. Alright guys, key points of performance here. You got to get a band, and you want to get a band that is going to be at a height of about your hip height, shoulder height, depending on how tall you are, will change your setup. Use a squat rack, loop it around the rail of the treadmill, wherever you got, so you can get the appropriate setup. And then we talk about split squat. A couple of things I want to break down is you should be on the back toe here. We're trying to work stability, and we're trying to work single leg strength coupled with the core exercise. I'll show you that in a second. But when you go into your split squat, train full range of motion. You look here, all this is in line. I'm not arching on the back. Keep that locked in. And then this front leg is vertical. So I should be looking like this when I do a basic split squat, not opening and closing this foot every time here. So get into a good, strong athletic position. Then we take it up a notch. We add in some rotation. Whatever leg is forward is the one, the leg that's forward is the one that I want to be closest towards the band. So that's gonna pull me that way. So come down. I got straight arms. The band's trying to pull me this way. So you're using your core, being engaged, and it's teaching you how to fire those muscles and be tight through your whole body. That's the Palloff split squat lunge. Get after it.